talking to us so many about journeys. Before we begin, let us say together January's prayer written by Year 3. In the name of
the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Today is the 25th of January and the feast day of the conversion of St. Paul. Listen to a story which tells of a man who went on a journey to Damascus and changed his life for the better.
Saul was an angry man who did not like Christians at all. He yelled and screamed at them.
I don't like you.
He beat them. He made nasty threats.
I'll pick you one.
And sometimes even killed them. Saul was definitely not a man anyone would want to fight.
On this particular day, Saul shoved into the city of Damascus. He wanted to, with his friends, he wanted the leaders of the city to give him permission to hurt more Christians. He and his friends were making their way along the dusty road. They were discussing what they were going to say to the leaders and bragging about how happy they would be to receive permission to persecute Christians when suddenly,
from out of heaven came the brightest light Saul had ever seen. The light surrounded him. He covered his eyes to try and shield the light. But it was so bright, it still hurt his eyes. He fell down on the ground trying to get away from it.
Then he heard a voice. It was unlike any voice he had ever heard, saying,
Saul, why do you want to persecute me?
Saul, not recognizing the voice, said,
Who are you?
The answer came back,
I am Jesus.
Of course, Saul was terribly afraid. He was shaking and trembling and could hardly speak. In a weak voice, he said,
Lord, what should I do?
Jesus replied,
Go into the city. Someone will meet you and tell you what to do.
The friends that were with him were astonished. They didn't see a light. They didn't see a person. They only heard the voice. They didn't have a clue what was happening.
When Saul was able to get up off the ground, he uncovered his eyes, but he couldn't see anything at all. The light was so bright that it had blinded him. His friends had to hold his hand and lead him to Damascus. For 3 whole days, he couldn't see anything at all.
While all of this was happening on the road outside the city of Damascus, something else was happening on the inside of the city. The Christians were becoming fearful because they heard that Saul was on his way. They knew he was a cruel man and did not like him. They heard of the terrible things he had done to other Christians and were getting quite worried.
There was a Christian man named Ananias who loved the Lord very much. God spoke to him in a vision, telling him to go down the street to find Saul. Now, Ananias had heard all of the stories about Saul, and he wasn't very fond of this plan. Ananias spoke to the Lord.
What if he hurts me? What if he even wants to kill me? I'm sure about this, Lord.
I'm sure we can all understand Ananias' hesitation to go out and find Saul.
The Lord spoke to Ananias again, reassuring him that everything would be fine. Ananias found the house where Saul was staying and went in for a visit. While he was there, he prayed for Saul, and the blindness left him.
I can see.
The Lord healed him so he could see again. Saul stayed in Damascus with the Christians. He became good friends with them and learned from them. It wasn't long before Saul became a preacher, teaching people about Jesus. Everyone was amazed. They couldn't believe this was the same person that had hated them so much and wanted to kill them.
Saul's journey became a journey in faith. His conversion led to him being named Paul and becoming a disciple of Jesus.
Although Saul is a poor man, his chosen heart shows examples of us in school values. Wisdom to know he had to change, joy, respect and love for the Lord, and kindness, understanding and belonging and thank of Christ. Please join us as we sing One More Step Along the World I Go.
And had to go home early.
In 1908, he went on his second Antarctic expedition, this time as leader on the ship Nimrod. The team left behind several crates of brandy and whiskey, which were found in Antarctica in 2010.
After the Nimrod expedition, Shackleton was regarded as a hero and he was awarded a medal by the Royal Geographical Society. He was also knighted becoming Sir Ernest Shackleton. He made money about extra travels. He also dabbled in Hungarian mining, selling stamps, and he created a tobacco company.
For his next expedition, Shackleton placed a newspaper ad asking for men to join him. The advertisement promised dangerous conditions, low wages, and cold temperatures.
Men wanted for hazardous journey, small wages, bitter cold, long months of complete darkness, constant danger, safe return doubtful, honour and recognition in case of success. Only Shackleton for Burlington's history.
On his third expedition in 1914, Shackleton's ship Endurance was trapped in the ice for almost a year. The team escaped by sailing across 1,300 kilometers of ocean in a small boat to the tiny, uninhabited South Georgia Island. Eventually, all of Shackleton's crew survived the journey.
Ernest Shackleton died from a heart attack in 1922 while on an expedition and was buried on the remote Atlantic island of South Georgia. There is a statue of the explorer outside the rock. London's Royal Geographical Society.
Sir Ernest Shackleton's journey was one of courage, hope, patience, and endurance. He said, "Through endurance we conquer." This is a lesson for us all that hard work leads to results.
Please join our hands as we pray. Dear Lord, In our journey with you, may we never lose sense of direction towards which we travel. Dear Lord, in our journey with you, may we never lose our sense of direction, never lose sight of the landmark towards which we travel, and should cloud or rain obscure our vision, may we draw closer to you so that our feet may tread in your footsteps. May your words be our encouragement and your love be our protection against the storms that assail us. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for coming to our assembly. I hope you enjoyed it.